Hello friends, today we'll discuss about pointers. Before that, please subscribe my channel for more updates and more videos so that others can see my videos also. So please subscribe my channel. Today I'm going to discuss about pointers topic. So what is a pointer? Say the pointer. See, the pointer in C language is a variable which stores the address of another variable. This variable can be of type int, char, array, function, or any other pointer. The size of the pointer depends on the architecture. However, in 32-bit architecture, the size of a pointer is 2 byte. Okay, so it depends on operating system. Some systems will have 32-bit operating system and some systems will have 64-bit operating system. So the main topic is pointer in C language is a variable. Pointer is a variable which stores the address of another variable. Okay, this variable can be of type int, char, array, function, or any other pointer. See, the pointer in C language is a variable which stores the address of another variable. Okay, this variable can be of type int, char, array, function, or any other pointer. Okay, and the size is depends on the operating system. Okay, one some systems will have 32 bit, some systems will have 64 bit operating system. Okay, and pointer is of size is 2 byte. Pointer size is 2 byte. So let us see, consider the example to define a pointer which stores the address of an integer. Okay, see, the following example is to define a pointer which stores the address of an integer. So how we will write? See, consider the following example. To define a pointer which stores the address of an integer. So for this I'll write as int n equal to 10. Okay, next int star p. Star is pointer. P is a pointer variable because we are writing star. Here asterisk star symbol is nothing but pointer variable equal to address of n. So here what do you mean by this line? Means variable p of type pointer is pointing to the address of the variable n of type integer. Okay, see, variable p of type pointer is pointing to the address of the variable n of type integer. Okay, so here pointer p variable is accessing the address of n. See, normally p variable will have one address in memory and n variable will also have address in the memory, but what this pointer is doing, it is accessing the address of another variable. Okay, see, one person is there, he is accessing the address of another person. So who is accessing the address of another person is called a pointer. So how to declare a pointer? Declaring a pointer, so the pointer in C language can be declared using asterisk symbol. Asterisk means star symbol. It is also known as indirection operator used to dereference operator. We can call it as indirection operator also. Okay, so the pointer in C language can be declared using asterisk symbol. You can call it as asterisk symbol. Okay, it is also known as indirection operator also, we can say. Okay, see how you will declare. I'll show one example. Int asterisk a, this is nothing but pointer to int. Char asterisk c, this is nothing but pointer to char. Okay, so if you see the example, pointer example, see, whenever you declare pointer, if there is any asterisk symbol before the variable name, we'll call it as it is a pointer variable of type integer. If whatever the data type is there, of type, that is integer. If char is there, of type character variable using pointer. So if you see an example of pointer, an example of using pointers to print the address and value, how it will be means, I will show in diagram. See, this is one box and this is one more box. So these are memories, and here I'll write, first of all I'll define the addresses of the two memory boxes. This is p, pointer p variable, and this is number variable. P is a pointer and number is a variable. Now I will store here, I'll write here address of this box AA3. Okay, this is a memory address of this pointer p variable, and this is memory address for the number variable FFF4 I'm writing. Okay, so here this is a pointer variable. And this is a number. This is a normal variable. We'll call it as normal This is a normal variable. Okay, so the p will access the address of number variable. So it will point So this will access the p will access the address of the number variable. So number variable, what is the address? FFF4. So then that is called a pointer. This pointer p variable accessing the address of another variable, that is number variable, storing the address of another variable. So that is called a pointer. And normally, and as it number variable will store it as some value 50. Okay. So here as you can see in the figure, pointer variable stores the address of number variable, that is FFF4. The value of number variable is 50, but the address of pointer variable p is AA3. Understood? So if you see the one example using pointer, we can now I'm going to print the value of a pointer variable p. Okay, let's see the pointer example as explained in the figure. Okay, whatever I explained in the figure, using that I'm going to write a program now. Okay, here see, suppose hash include stdio.h hash include conio.h void main I'm writing. Okay, and in this I will declare first number variable int number as it is, whatever I said in the figure program diagram, in that only I am writing. So int number equal to 50 I am storing. Then int star p, next p equal to ampersand number. See, ampersand number means address of a number. See, what is a pointer? Pointer will store the address of the another variable. Here another variable is nothing but number. Okay, so ampersand number means address of a number is storing into p. See, this is a pointer definition. This line is a pointer definition. Whenever you say star p means you have to think that p will store some address of another variable. So that is a pointer. So here it will stores the address of number variable. Okay, and next printf address of p variable is percentile x. See, here percentile x means it will print the address in the string format. Okay, this is a percentile x is a format specifier which will print the address in a string format. Okay, if you write percentile u, you will print the address in the number format. Okay, please don't confuse on that. Okay, what is percentile x means? Okay, so p contains the address of the number. Okay, address of the number and also so address of the number and next we'll see printf value of p variable. P variable is percentile d slash n star p. Okay. So here if you compile, you will get the output as, what you will get output? First you will get the address of a number, address of number variable is FFFF4. Okay, and next you will get address of P variable is also FFF4, and next we will get value of P variable. Star P means you will get the value, only P means you will get the address of another variable. Okay, so value of P variable is 50 you will get as per diagram whatever you wrote. So number variable you will get the address, first you are printing the address. Okay, and next you are getting address of a variable. Okay, so address of a variable, next value. Understood? So address of a p variable, address of a p variable is FF4, address of a number variable is FF4, and value of p variable is 50 you will get. So this is, friends, how we will use a pointer. So pointer is nothing but a, it will print the address of, pointer p is nothing but address of another variable, that is number variable. Okay, this is about pointers, friends. Thank you. If you have any doubts, you can please comment me, and please like my video and also subscribe my channel. Thank you.